For years, Diana was my sole handler at the agency. She supplied information and secrecy, and I sold perfection. We had trust. Then last August 10th, Diana brought the agency to its knees. She flushed all accounts, cut off all communication lines, exposed the agents, and used the confusion to vanish. Now the reformed agency has finally tracked her down. Offered me the contract. One day, I will think of this as just another job. After all, this is what I do.
Hello and welcome everybody to another stream. My name is Corrupted2108, and continuing with Hitman Week, Hitman Throwback Week. Today we are playing Hitman Absolution. And as you saw in the opening cinematic, the story gets a little dark. So, without further ado, let's get into it. The difference between Blood Money and the earlier Hitman games is there was really only, I think, four difficulties. It was easy. It was normal, hard, expert, and master, or easy, normal, hard, and expert. This one, there is actually a purist difficulty, and it says no help, no guides, no interface, just a crosshair. This is I will say I've played this difficulty. This is ridiculous, but it's rather fun. I'm not going to be doing that today though. I'm just going to go in on normal, and we're just going to have a little bit of fun today. Probably won't end up completing it all in one sitting. I would like to, but I was trying to do that with Blood Money yesterday as well. And there are levels that just are long. Like yesterday, some of the pathing you actually have to wait for. If you want to get Silent Assassin rating, that's what really needed to happen, and I mean, it didn't, and that's why a lot of the gunfights happened, because either it was just too long with waiting for enemy pathing, or just whatever. This is a little different, but there are environments and levels in the game that are ridiculously detailed, and this game's a lot of fun. So, like I said, without further ado, let's jump in.
Listen to me. I need you to be brave. A man will come and take you away. I cannot go with you. This is how it has to be. This man is different. He will protect you. Please don't judge him for what he might do. I'm sorry. Maybe someday you will understand.
Seven. This is Benjamin Travis. The money has been wired to your account. Welcome to Chicago. I appreciate you taking this assignment, 47. It is never easy targeting our own, but Diana Burnwood's treason must be dealt with. Quitsend in one of the teams, but this is a job for a scalpel, not a hammer.
Reasons are irrelevant.
Exactly. Good luck, 47.
Sir. Yeah, it's an ice cream truck. Yeah, I know. I'll get rid of him. Hey, get out of here. We don't want anything.
What about your partner?
What partner?
During this assignment, key game elements will be highlighted. First of all, try to kill with discretion and try to remain undetected. Let's look at the interface. In the lower left corner, the blue bar indicates your health. Next to it is the radar. Use it to keep track of enemies, objectives, and exit points. In the lower right corner, you can see what weapon you have selected and if it's hidden. Next to the weapon, the yellow bar indicates how much instinct you have available. If it is depleted, you cannot rely on instinct abilities.
So this is the prologue. It'll give you like your starting hints for entering the new game and stuff like that. Like this.
According to ICA Division Chief Benjamin Travis, my former handler Diana Burnwood has gone rogue, taking with her a valuable agency asset, a girl named Victoria. After months underground, Diana's safe house has been located, a heavily guarded mansion on the shores of Lake Michigan. My objective? Eliminate Diana and retrieve the girl. Personal note, Diana saved my life. Although the grounds for termination are just, I take no pride in this assignment. From here on out, I shall refer to her only as my target. Must not get personally involved.
it's not just ran. It's when you pull the left, when you pull the left trigger, it'll zoom in so you could actually target. It's not just a reticle. Which, don't get me wrong. The guard up ahead will try to arrest you if he spots you, so keep low and try to slip past unnoticed. Don't get me wrong. The older games, it definitely does. It's nice to just have like the reticle where it's like, okay, reticle turns red, boom. But like you can actually target certain body parts, which is also nice.
Approach the cover in front of you. When you are in cover, it is harder for your enemies to spot you.
Not with the shine on my bald head. Jesus.
Items found in the world can be used as close combat weapons, or you can use them to distract your enemies. Throw the wrench at the buckets to distract the guard.
What the?
Excellent. Slip past while the guard is distracted. Then increase your precision by steadying your aim. The body is now hidden. The container has room for one more body and still has room for you to hide.
I know it's the client's call, but that doesn't mean I have to like it.
Use your fiber wire to silently eliminate the guard up ahead. Clean kill. Notice the fiber wire allows you to drag your target immediately.
You can also use the environment for kills.
Agent 47's training and supreme senses allow him to keenly perceive his surroundings.
Paramedics are on their way.
You can't hit him with the, you can't knock him out with the book, unfortunately, unless you're like right behind him.
Clean kill. Remember to hide the body. Bodies left in plain sight will alert your enemies.
In the future, in if upcoming levels, they'll actually like implement a, or actually in this level, they're gonna, it's like a point system or like a merit system, where if you knock somebody out or kill somebody, they'll deduct points. But if you hide the body, then it'll give the points back. So like I killed the two with the environment.
Now full. There is no more room for additional bodies or for you to hide.
Yeah, so like I can't even get that body to hide it. Although I can drag him. So we'll drag him, get him out of the way, and we'll go from there.
Clean kill. Remember to hide the body. Bodies left in plain sight will alert your enemies.
Bye.
Use instinct or consult the radar to locate the exit.
I'm fucking right here.
Use instinct to anticipate enemy movement.
Looks like the chef's cooking up a storm. I tell you, this gig is like watching paint dry. But at least the service is good.
Edged and piercing weapons can be used for deadly throws as well as distractions. Focus on a target. Clean kill. You can dump the body over the railing. Your current weapon is unsilenced and might alert your enemies. Consider using your silenced silver baller pistols. The greenhouse up ahead will require a disguise to infiltrate unnoticed. You are disguised as a gardener. In this disguise, you are allowed to be in the greenhouse area. Be mindful that other gardeners see through your disguise if you come too close, so keep a safe distance. Getting into the greenhouse will bring you close to the gardener. He will get suspicious, but you can use your instinct to trick him. Trick the gardener. Keep using instinct until you are safely inside. The guards up ahead will not be suspicious, but you should keep a lookout for other gardeners.
The house since we got here. No school, no friends coming over. A bit odd, don't you think? I don't know. Maybe.
Sorry, pal, new rules. This area is off limits unless you're security or guests of Miss Burnwood.
What? Why? What if we need to use the restroom?
What am I, an information board? Just following orders, pal. Perfect. Just perfect. I'm gonna kill these maintenance clowns.
Nah, the guards have been dealt with. Doing so, you regain some instinct.
Come on, let's check out the boats.
The guards are preoccupied. You can kill them or sneak past. The choice is yours.
And settle happily for a roof over my head.
I'll sneak past them this time.
Been sleeping on couches since Angie kicked me out.
Leaving people alive is cleaner, but might complicate your effort to remain undetected. Yet this is the mark of the silent assassin, to leave the world around him unaware and untouched.
Infiltrate the mansion and terminate Diana Burnwood. In Victoria, bring her in, unharmed. She is very dear to me and the agency.
What? You're kidding. Wait, are you sure? It's not prostate cancer. I could kiss you. I mean, that's great news. Oh, man. You made my day. Yeah, thanks, Doc. Yeah. And I thought I was a goner. Yeah. Doc, I gotta run. Duty calls. And thank you so much. You have a nice day, too. Yeah, bye.
Little did he know, he was a goner.
You are now inside the mansion. Your current disguise will be suspicious to the mansion guards. Either find a new disguise or try to remain undetected. Subdue or kill. The choice is yours. Either way, he won't be waking up anytime soon. The mansion guard disguise gives you full access to the mansion interior. Be mindful that other mansion guards see through your disguise if you come too close, so keep a safe distance.
No way to hide the body. Oh well. Over you go. Bye. Okay. Got quite the weapons cabinet. More than a couple of shotguns, rifles, handguns. Pick up the evidence.
Removing the evidence will award you rating points and instinct. Beyond this door, the rating system will be turned on. It will monitor your playstyle and reward your progress. You can see it in the top left corner. As always, how you handle your assignment is entirely up to you. Good luck.
Yeah, so they pretty much tell you, like, you want to kill everybody? Go ahead, but your score's not will also reflect it. So, like, if you kill absolutely everybody, it'll be a negative score. But if you're stealthy and move with reason, you'll do relatively okay.
Better haul ass. The head hates having to repeat himself.
Use instinct to locate objects of interest.
Shortly. The girl's in her room and will remain so for the time being. For those of you who do not know the drill, I will personally appoint a close protection host for each client on a 6-hour shift cycle. You will not, I repeat, not leave your VIP side for any reason during your shift. Any breach of procedure will result in immediate termination.
Yeah. So as you saw, I subdued the guy, but I lost 160 points. I hid the body, so now gave it back.
Must have some kind of baggage.
This is Alpha. I don't care. Hey, who opened those blinds? We're sitting ducks in here. Hey, nice view. Never noticed that.
So you cause a distraction, and the guy comes up to lower the blinds again. So 9 target casualty netted me 400 didn't give me 400 points. It took away 400 points. And then hiding the body will take some of that back. Yeah.
If your score is high enough, you will unlock an assassin technique. Open the notebook to see your next unlock.
According to ICA Division Chief Benjamin Travis.
So, this is my score currently. These are my challenges. My inventory. So, avoid using disguises. It adds a score modifier. Head of security drugged. He's not sleeping. He's just resting his eyes. And then you do an accidental kill with the piano. And each level has certain challenges to complete.
Closing in on target.
Well done, 47. Now remember, Diana brought this on herself. She betrayed us, the agency, the code, everything we stand for. She is too dangerous to be left alive. Think about that when you pull the trigger.
Report 47.
I should kill you. did you do this?
47!
Damn it, what's wrong with this thing?
We all have our limits, even you, 47. We used to have honor.
Diana, I...
No. I had to take her away from the doctors. I knew you would understand.
Fuck. Something's not right.
You won't last long.
There's no time.
You still have a chance.
In my robe. A letter. Now go. Take the girl and run. Before Travis finds out. Please. Do not let her turn into you. Promise me.
I promise.
Running is noisy and makes it easier for your enemies to spot you. Agent 47 can deal with enemies swiftly and with great precision. Note that while you are focusing on your targets, you expend instinct rapidly. Turn the camera to focus on your enemy, then lock the shot. Fatal damage. Focus on the next enemy. Make sure to deal fatal damage to all four enemies. All enemies are dead.
You owe me money.
Collecting all the ammo.
You know who I am.
I know. She's dead, isn't she?
Come on, stay close to me.
Where are we going?
Get in. It's done.
Excellent work, 47. Bring the girl to the extraction point.
Why did the agency want you?
I don't know. I guess I might have...
Diana did this for you. Why?
Please, she was my only friend. She took me away from the doctors.
Tell me about the doctors.
It's really blurry. Like, really bad dream. Why?
We need to go.
Sir, there's nobody here. I think the asset's gone AWOL.
God damn it! I was afraid it couldn't do it. But every agent...
to get off the streets. The agency knows my secure locations, and they will be searching for us. This is the safest place I know.
Can I come with you?
You need to hide, till I know what's going on.
Oh, it was you who called?
Yes.
Oh, you must be Victoria. Come on in, child.
Thank you for your help. This girl is important. Take this.
We will take good care of her, my son.
Diana said you need that necklace. Don't lose it.
Will you come back?
I'll be watching. Birdie, we need to meet.
Your actions precede you, my man. Yeah, I gotta say, I admire a man with the courage to shit where he eats. I'm guessing you're in need of some information, and I just might be willing to play ball. But first, I got a favor to ask. You listening? Sweet. Well, see, this is local upstart calling himself the King of Chinatown. Not exactly the understated type. I would really like him to hand in his resignation, if you catch my drift. Now this king, he resides at the pagoda in the center of town, where a unit of dirty cops guard his every move. He rarely leaves the crowd, except to meet up with his dealer in a pad overlooking the square. Yeah, he's also got a swanky European ride parked in a nearby alley. And that's all I got, Holmes. So, call me back when you're done. Got it?
Okay. So, as I said, you can do this one of two ways. You can do this stealthily, you can do this going guns blazing. Guns blazing is more difficult only because of the fact that you do incur a lot of gunfire, especially when the option to do this all stealthily is a thing. I've done it both ways. I did it when it was first released on the 360. And I also, again, played this game when it was re-released on the Xbox One, and everything was like remastered in complete HD, which this is the one that we're playing on today. So. So if I use instinct, I can see where all the cops are, I can see where certain objectives are, and I can also see where my target is. If I go over here, there's this car, there's a cop guarding his car.
There are countless ways to assassinate the King of Chinatown. 12 of these assassinations will unlock challenges. To view the challenges, consult the notebook. A completed challenge will grant a permanent score bonus. The more challenges you complete, the higher your potential score. Happy hunting.
So we've got chameleon, which is essentially fresh disguises. I've already collected all the evidence. Avoid getting spotted, suit only, make something explode. Only targets eliminated. Dropping the target down an elevator shaft. Accidental kill, so like the environment, same thing with this. Dropping some, you know, pushing somebody down an elevator shaft is both considered the man down challenge and the drop dead challenge. One bullet for two targets. Evidence recovered and then on scene. Poison the drugs that's actually in the apartment. And also there's poisoning the coffee. So there's actually a whole lot of things that you can do. Like I gotta find the drug dealer so I can suit him. Which I think he might be upstairs. So that's this is health, in case one might need it. Poison somewhere. Where is it? Oh, that might be. Well, How was I spotted? You gonna put the gun away?
What appears to be a crime scene.
All right, keep away, sir. For your own sake.
So bring your mean ass to my home.
I need information.
Well, that's my business. Information. You need information, I find information.
At a price, of course.
You're damn right at a price. Of course.
A girl named Victoria. The agency wants her bad. I need to know why.
No, wait. the agency. You want me to snoop around the agency? Were you crazy? Yeah, you crazy. All right, what is it worth to you?
Name your price.
Well, tools.
Now listen to the city. If anyone mentions a girl, you know what to do.
I'll call you.
You do that. For what? Still have a chance.
The wits end in one of the teams, but this is a job.
47.
Why did you do this? Yes.
Terminus Hotel, room 899.
So I asked my birds a question, Holmes, and the answer came back in the shape of a name. Industry VIP who seems to have taken a special interest in your girl. Dexter occupies the Terminus's top floor, and his thugs have the place sealed off tight. Still, a man of your skills and resources should be able to find several access points. Good luck, Holmes.
So as you can see, I've given up all of my quote-unquote tools of my trade, and now I just have this little six-shooter here. And this is where, this is the beginning of where the game starts to really get, get away from the stealth, although there is a sense of stealth, of course, but it takes a step away from that, and then we'll go towards essentially full-on combat. So here we're approaching the Terminus Hotel, and it's a pretty big place, as you can see, and we can't just waltz in like we own the joint. We actually have to find another way in. And this is actually a pretty well done level, in my opinion. I know my opinion, it's just one person's opinion, but so Hotel Terminus deteriorated late 19th century by the look of it, should provide several entry points. I believe this is supposed to be Chicago. I'm not entirely sure what... I know it's not like New York or anything, but it's supposed to, I think it's actually supposed to be Chicago. So. Oh shit, we can just walk right in. Oh, but we can't because there's too many guns and everything here. That's okay. We'll find our own way in. We'll just enter in via the old sewer system. We're back outside. Not where we want to go.
A fuse box, right?
You know, that's funny because, meant to just like smack him around a bit.
Probably look to get off at a lower floor and look for a more subtle entry point.
What am I saying? A pro like you, you probably got the whole thing figured out, don't you? All right, go get him.
Are the stairwells secure?
Uh-huh.
Seal up tight. Nobody disturbs Mr. Dexter without our permission.
Good. And no incidents, you hear me? I want this operation.
Oh, hey, mister. You must be new around here.
Yo. Yeah. Yeah, I got you. What you need? You're joking, right? Are you nuts?
Oh, hey, mister. You must be...
is like spreading bad vibes out here. Hello, anyone?
Sorry for all the technicolor. There we go. That's what I wanted to do. Well, he's sort of hidden. They're not going to find him on the 8th floor, that's for sure.
Thank you.
Nope, that's going down. Don't need to go down. Going a little,
her name doing a little vent. Victoria, and she's worth a lot of fucking money. She's some kind of enhanced wonder child or something. Point is, we go in, we grab her, we hang on to her.
Sounds like something you came up with in one of your labs.
Oh, who the fuck asked for your opinion anyway?
You're a fucking asshole, you know that?
You know, your job is to shut up, do what I say, and look good. And you do look good, honey.
Sweet talker.
Jesus Christ! Don't you ever fucking knock!
Oh. Good work, Sanchez. Yeah.
What is he? Is he a cop? Is he a PI or something?
Well, fuck me gently.
What the fuck?
That ain't no fucking private eye! That's a fucking ghost! That's a myth! That's a fucking hitman!
Hitman?
Oh, shit!
What the fuck are you talking about?
This fucking changes everything! This changes everything!
What the fuck are we gonna do with him?
Knock, knock, knock! Housekeeping!
Shh.
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, we got us a little mess in here. Why don't you come on in and clean it up?
For you.
Yeah, that'd be good.
Clean out?
Sure, come on in, darling. Atta girl.
Oh my god, these goats!
Oh god! You fucking animal!
And that's what I call a sweet slice. You know, nothing would give me more pleasure than to kill you right here and now. Me kill the legendary hitman, yeah, but I don't need that kind of attention. So, oh dear, you've done a bad, bad thing. Well, now they won't be looking for a killer, will they, huh? Killer.
Yeah!
early yeehaw. But this is a fucking yeehaw! Fucking Christmas! Here, take a slash. Nah. On second thought. Tinkle, tinkle, little jar.
Wait, could you please not do that? This is a bad plan.
Come on, darling. You better put a giddy up in your step.
Go.
Everything clear.
So now we're in the library.
Everything clear.
no. Just for one guy.
This gotta be big.
Oh, that didn't work. Great, backups arrived. Shit. Oh shit. Well then. Will he run around to get the ammo? Oh! Oops.
hell is this guy? Well, he's jumping buildings, dodging helicopter fire. What's going on here?
Gotta be ex-military. Yeah, you know, my cousin Anthony. He's combat soldiers with the... what is that? Oh, that PTSD. You know, and some of these guys, when they snap, they fucking snap, you know?
Yep, hippie's freaking out trying to flush his pot. Poor hippie. Swipe knife with bong.
You know what's funny? I got a call to this floor a couple weeks back for the domestic service, right? And the landlord was complaining that the building smelled like pine trees. I guess we know now why.
So this crackhead, he breaks his leg in a fight, right? He walks to the hospital by himself. Guy walks up to the front desk, and the nurse starts screaming. Turns out, there's a small axe stuck in his head. No shit! The guy was so strung out, he didn't even notice.
That's something you don't see every day.
No, just every other week, right?
Anyone seen a combination for the safe?
gonna have is a warrant if you're here on business, okay?
Hey, listen, Chief, this ain't a bust. The guy we're looking for is extremely dangerous.
We're all dangerous, man. We're all naked under our clothes, and our animal hearts beat with the same blood.
And if we don't nail this guy...
Bucks, I know you from somewhere. Where the hell?
Station. Some kind of murder and...
Number 6.
Hey, look at that. I unlocked a challenge.
After Victoria. I need to stop him
before he gets too close.
Man, he already too close. You want my advice? You take that girl and you run.
I never did believe in running.
According to my sources, girl is in Chicago. Me and the boys are leaving ASAP. I need you along to spearhead the operation. Are you in? Wade.
I heard you. You want me to snatch some chick?
Name's Victoria. Dom is gonna call you, tell you how to find her. She's in hiding somewhere. You got that?
That's a lot of hassle for one chick. She must be special. I need to bring my boys. That means double my fee.
Take Lenny with you. He can bring her back when you find her.
Lenny, limp dick? Triple my fee. Sorry, the kid's a dipshit.
25.
39.
26.
37.
30.
35.
Deal. Lenny, come give the man a line.
Come on, limp dick. Limp Dick Lenny.
Shut up, Wade!
I like good old Wade, I really do.
Son of a bitch makes my skin crawl.
That's probably why I like him.
Now, Blake Dexter's a ruthless son of a bitch for sure, but the guy you really need to worry about is the
business partner Dom Osman, owner of the Vixen Club over on Bristol Street. This prank is bad news, Holmes, even by my standards. I mean, clever and really connected. And it's only a matter of time before he tracks down your girl at the orphanage. How do you know about that?
Hey, Chicago knows, I know. Dom ain't all that different.
Send me his picture.
Okay, I am going to call it there, strictly because I forgot how relatively violent some of these cutscenes are, and be it that it's a game, and I'm going to try to upload it to YouTube, I don't want YouTube giving me a hassle for it, so just about the 2-hour mark, I'm going to cut it here. If this is able to go up, no problem. Then I will continue playing. I'm going to continue playing regardless, but it may only be here on Twitch. And that's if I can't upload it to YouTube. Obviously, if I can't upload it to YouTube, I'll let you all know the next time I stream. Or you'll know, obviously, if you can't find it in my YouTube channel. But yeah, I'm gonna cut it here, only because, like I said, I really don't know if it's gonna give me a hassle or not, but thank you very much for joining me this afternoon. My name's Corrupted2108. This has been Hitman Absolution. I hope to be able to continue this here on Twitch, and that you join me. Until then, I'll catch y'all next time.